Hi there! In this video, we'll demonstrate how to create and print a plot layout. We're gonna use the sample project electrical end result for the demo. You can download it from the YouTube video description. In the toolbar, click on the plot layout wizard. You can enter a name for the plot and click OK to create it. In the sheet dialog, you can access the sheet product database by clicking on the three dots button. In the title field dialog, you can open the title field product database. Select the route pause scale tab. Change the global scaling to 0.5 so that the title field fits to the A3 sheet. Then press OK to continue. In the insert model, part model section dialog, we can select the objects that we want to insert in the plot. First, insert the installation model from the first floor, level 2. On the right, you will see a preview of the selected model. Next, set the scale to 1 to 100 and press the insert button. Position the model dynamically at the upper left corner of the sheet. Select the section A from the first floor. Set the scale to 1 to 75, then press the insert button. Insert the section below the floor plan. Press the close button to close the dialog. The information entered in this dialog will be automatically inserted for all title fields produced within this model. Open the render mode. Activate the Render Ray Tracing Advanced to generate a rendered image. Now, click on Export Rendered Image to File. Type a name and select the image file from the drop-down list. Click on Save button to continue. You can customize the size of the image in the resolution field. The higher the value, the better the quality of the image, but also the size of the file. Enter 8000 for the width and press Tab to automatically update the height. Press OK to continue. Go back to the plot layout. In the Insert menu, select External Resource and then Image File as XREF. Select the rendered image you just created and press Open. In the Placement and Visualization options, activate the checkbox at Position Dynamically. Select the Tab Route Pause Scale tab and change the global scaling to 1 to 5. Insert the image to the plot with left mouse click. Open the 2D model by double-clicking left mouse. Zoom in to the WC rooms. Activate the dimensioning function from the toolbar. To insert the dimensioning line in the model, left mouse click to start it. Move the cursor to the next point and left mouse click again. Now, move the cursor to position the dimensioning line in the model. Once you have finished to place the dimensioning lines in the WC rooms, select the Part Models function in the toolbar. Click on the New Part Model button. You can enter a name and description for the part model. The part model can be defined as either a rectangle or polygon shape. Select the rectangle option and define a window that includes the WC rooms by using left mouse button. Here you see a preview of the part model you just created. Click on the Add to Presentation List button. Press Close to close the dialog. And go back to the plot layout. Activate the Model Part Model section function from the plot layout toolbox. Select the WC's detail. Set the scale to 1 to 50. Activate Display Contour option. And insert it in a plot next to the floor plan model. Next, let's insert some free text in a plot. In the text field, you can type floor plan. Set the value in the height field to 5. Select the frame ref line tab. Activate the border checkbox. Press right mouse to open the context menu and select Edit Properties. Rewrite the text to Section A. Next, rewrite the text to WC's detail. Activate the legend function from the plot layout toolbox. You can position it dynamically above the title field. Select the legend and click on the node to resize it. Double-click on the legend to access its properties. Click on the legend list button. Select the distribution board entry, then press the move up button twice. Now right mouse click on one outline and select rename. You can shorten the lamp's name now. Now, let's see how to manage centralized and automatic project and model information. Activate the project details from the plot layout toolbox. As seen previously, the inserted tags are added in the title field. The project details is automatically used in all title fields within this project. Activate the model details. The model details are directly related to the plot itself and can differ between plots. Now, activate the revision function from Plot Layout Toolbox. Enter a new code in the revision field. Type a description in the Description 1 field. Click on the Add button to continue. Here you can insert a date and signature. It is possible to manage the layer's visibility on your plots. Activate the layer wizard from the toolbar. Left mouse click on the layer once it is highlighted to hide it. Right mouse click to see list layers that you have hidden thus far. Select a layer from the list to make it visible again. Access the PDF printer from the toolbar. We're gonna use a PDF creator because it has good performance for high quality DPI outputs. PDF creator is by default available in the DDS-CAD 10 installer under the Tools tab. In the Printer tab, you can select the printer and sheet size. In the Pen Font tab, you can configure the thickness of the layers and more. Press the Print button to continue. Here you can enter a name for the file. Click the Save button to continue. It is possible to print high-quality plots in PDF using, for example, DPI values of 1200 and higher. PDF Creator is able to cope perfectly with this and will present the information superbly.